24 years after the original Toy Story dropped in theaters, we now have a Toy Story 4, and that means it's time to stop and rank all four Toy Story movies from the worst to the best. If you're new here, my name is Sean Chandler, and I started this channel because I was driving everyone around me crazy talking about movies way too much. If you can relate, you're probably in the right place. Consider clicking that subscribe button. With that in mind, go ahead and join me down below in the comment section. Share your ranking of all four Toy Story movies. Now, the average Rotten Tomatoes score of these films is like a 98%. And if you throw out Armand White's negative reviews for the last two movies, it's up to like a 99.5%. So it's safe to say they're all great. So we're picking between awesome movies, so let's be civil down below. One final thing before we get started, this video is brought to you by Audible. Get a free audiobook download of your choice and a 30-day free trial at audibletrial.com/Sean Chandler. There's over 180,000 titles to choose from for your iPhone, Android, Kindle, or MP3 player. I personally listened to over 50 books last year. I love Audible. Get your free audiobook and trial at audibletrial.com/Sean Chandler. And with that said, let's get started. Coming in last place is Toy Story 2. It has all the fun and emotions of the original film, but it finds a new way to explore these characters and themes. This time the group dynamics are very different as Woody is off in this store with a new set of characters and Buzz has to lead a rescue mission, which leads to a bunch of fun stuff as all the characters get in on the actual adventure of trying to rescue Woody. Add into the mix, they have this subplot about Buzz Lightyear's dad that has all sorts of Star Wars homages inside of it. That's just a lot of fun to see in this context. What this movie does so well is touch on childhood nostalgia and how growing up means change and moving on. The Jesse storyline captures this probably better than anything else when it does that story song montage. It's just wonderful visual storytelling that captures a feeling and emotion. Now, there's no big mistakes here. It's only last because, well, something had to be last. And the story here and the adventure isn't quite as engaging or rewatchable. In third place is Toy Story 3. They found a way to keep this franchise fresh and exciting by making a prison escape film by having our toys getting stuck at Sunnyside Daycare. Lotso might be the nastiest of our Toy Story villains in that we get this backstory of what's turned him into this hardened guy that just doesn't really care all that much about other toys. Throw it in the mix, you get fun new additions like Ken that has a real nice dynamic with Barbie, and it's always fun to see Michael Keaton show up in films like this, even in just voice talent. Once again, our whole gang gets in on the action here, and these stakes have never felt higher, and they build the tension so well that when you get to that furnace sequence, I actually believed that they were going to kill off all of our favorite toys and burn them to death, which was probably a silly fear as it is a children's movie from Pixar. Since the movie takes place years after the original film and Andy's all grown up and going off to college, it's able to evoke extra emotions from us as you can really sense the passage of time. Things really are changing, and because of this, it's able to come to such a satisfying conclusion for the Andy trilogy. Our runner-up is Toy Story. The original computer animated film and our first trip to the toy chest remains a classic and one of the best. At the center of this zany world is Buzz Lightyear, this toy that doesn't know that he's a toy. And this just sets up all kinds of hilarious shenanigans and adventures for our characters to get into. But the heart of the film is, of course, Woody, who loves Andy so much, but he's also a very jealous and insecure person. And this sets up this story that, while fantastical as it's about toys coming to life, manages to touch on very human emotions, both through Woody's journey in realizing that he shouldn't be behaving and responding the way that he is, but also just in the way that it touches on growing up, emotions, the way we connect with the things around us, and what we truly value about life. Of course, that's the subtext of the film, the emotional undercurrent, but the actual action of the film, the adventure about Woody and Buzz trying to get back to Andy is perfectly paced. It's set up to have all kinds of little adventures that keep being different and amusing in different ways. And then it sets up Sid as this great villain because he doesn't know that toys are alive. So he's torturing them because he just thinks they're little pieces of plastic, though we see them as these living creatures, which is just a really funny dynamic. Well, other studios have gone bigger and more ambitious with their computer animated films. Few have been able to capture the fun and emotions of the original story about some toys. But coming in first place is Toy Story 4. When they first announced this film, I was as cynical and skeptical as anyone. The third film ended so well that it just seemed like a big risk to take a fourth trip to the toy chest. And I really didn't think the trailer sold the movie all that well. But within the first 10 minutes, I realized how Toy Story 3 ended the Andy trilogy for the group perfectly. But that doesn't mean each individual character's journey is done. You immediately realize Woody probably wouldn't be a little girl's favorite toy. So what does Woody do when he's not necessary anymore? This movie gets to continue his story and that journey for him, where he still has all the insecurities and faults that he's always had, but this time he really gets to be the hero and discover who he is when he's not defined by his relationship to others. Add to the mix, you've got a bunch of new characters, Forky, Duke Kaboom, the stuffed animals, who are all scene stealers in their own unique and hilarious ways, which make this movie probably the funniest of the four films. Then you got Gabby Gabby, who's probably the most complex villain inside of this entire franchise. She does villainous things and you want to see her stopped, but then she suddenly becomes this very sympathetic character in the second half of the film. And by the end of it, you're actually rooting for her and want her to find happiness. And all of this leads to a tearjerker of a conclusion. These movies have always been about childhood and evoking nostalgia, but this film is about parenting and letting go. And as a parent, that means it kind of touched me on a whole other level than the other three films. So for me, it comes in at number one. If you enjoyed this ranking, check out that playlist right over there for my ranking of a bunch of other top animated franchises. The Disney revival, the Disney Renaissance, the Lego movies, How to Train Your Dragon, all that fun stuff right over there. Remember to check out Audible. Thank you so much for watching and keep talking movies too much.